guys, it's Leonor with LDM Creations, and today I'm going to be making an attempt to do a trifold card. I saw this on the web, and the first thing that we're going to do is I kind of have created a template, so you have an idea what we're going to be doing. It's basically going to be a trifold card this way, okay? So what you're going to be doing is you're going to be scoring your first one, and because my page is at 8.5 by 11 and this is plain cardstock, you're going to go ahead and score the first one at 3 5/8. So I'm going to go 3 5/8, okay? And the next one is 7 5/16, and basically it's the 7 and it's right before the 3/8. So I kind of have to, I guess, move it. Let's see, I'm going to try to get it here. Let's see, and I'm going to try to score it because it's an 11, it's not even. So you get an idea. Basically, it's going to have to fold three ways. Okay, so this way. Okay, so you know it's a little long sometimes, but it's the best that I can do because it's not at 11 even. So what I'm gonna do is, after I've done that, okay, I went ahead and that's my basic card. Let me move my scoring board out, and then the next thing you're gonna do, okay, what I'm gonna do is, I'm going to go ahead and grab a ruler and go down from one corner to the other. And I'm going to go down about maybe 4.5 inches. Okay. And then I'm going to put my ruler out this way here. Okay. So you're going to cut your card as deep as you want. And you're just going to use a craft knife. So I'm going to go ahead and cut it from one edge, to the other. And so I'm going to get my Martha Stewart punch, and then I'm going to punch out the border along in here. So let me start, and I'm just going to stand up here to start. So then I'm gonna line up the second one. Okay. So now I have the base of the card here. Okay. And what I'm going to be doing next is I'm going to go ahead and decorating it with some of my flowers and my sentiments. So I'm going to be doing this as a happy birthday. And I have a stamp already set up, ready to go. And let's go ahead and start decorating this card. Okay, so let me get closer here. So I have a 6x6 piece of paper, and believe it or not, this one was from Halloween, but I like this orangey with the flowers on it. So basically what I did is I went and married these together, and I folded the paper going this way just to see how my fold was going to go on the card, okay? So I'm going to go ahead and cut it with the craft knife. So he has some dimension. You can actually probably use another decorative punch on this one too, but I'm gonna use that. Okay, so that's gonna be that. And then after I line it up, I'm gonna make sure that I have it here, and then I'm just gonna go ahead and cut the excess. Let me show you. I'm cutting the excess of the paper. Okay, so now I have it in here. Okay. All right, so let's go ahead and adhere this. Careful to line them up correctly. Okay, here you go. So they are lined up in there. Okay, so then for my sentiment, I'm gonna make it a happy birthday card. And see, I have a noble here, but it's a little big. So let me try. I think I'm gonna do maybe a circle. I think I'm gonna do a bunch of circle. Okay, so I defined my happy birthday stamp, and I'm gonna go ahead and stamp it with my Stay Sun on my smaller scallop. And this one is the 2-inch scallop. So let's go ahead and do that. So let's be very happy birthdays, and then let's mat it with the other side with the bigger scallop. Their smaller scallop here. Okay, so I'm gonna put it here on the side, and then what I'm gonna do is I have this really pretty ribbon, but trying to see if I'm gonna use this one, or maybe I'll just use, you know what, I think I'm just gonna use this one here. Let me just use a very small strip of this one here, and that's a glitter paper. Let's see, cut it maybe like 1/4 of an inch, a very small strip. Sorry, I'm covering this. So I can put it up here. And then let me cut it right there. Okay. So I get a little elegant strip in here, and for this one I'm gonna use glue because my scotch tape is too thick. Okay. So I have that. Okay. And now what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna mount the happy birthday on the corner here, but I'm gonna put some foam tape. That's my doggy barking in the background. Okay. So we're gonna go here, happy birthday, okay. Okay, and then we're gonna use some matching flowers to go ahead and finish it off. And you can buy these ones on my shop. And I'm using hot glue for these ones. Okay, so let's go ahead and do some hot glue. Okay, that's one. So another one here. And then one right here. And then what I'm gonna do also is I'm gonna go ahead and add some, probably some distress ink maybe on top to make the punch stand up. So let me go ahead and do that and come back. Okay, so I went ahead and distressed the edges. Okay, so remember that you're probably gonna have to do both sides to distress them, because when you open it up, you know, the card shows up. So let me go ahead and finish it up. I have also a Martha Stewart little butterfly punch. And what I'm gonna do, I think I'm gonna put one here in the corner so it kind of stands out. And of course now it doesn't wanna work. So let me try the hot glue and show us what they have. Okay, I think I'm gonna put another one probably here in the next fold. So there's the card, guys. Very simple. I saw it from this lady, and I believe she's from the UK, and she made it seem really simple. And I really like the way the detail comes out. And basically, you can use this with no machine whatsoever, all done by hand. Okay. So very simple. That's the card for today. And then you can just put your sentiment either way. You can put it this way or you can put it this way. I think I'm gonna put mine in this one. And then you can use one of those long envelopes to put your card in, you know, since it's a skinny card. It's basically a brochure size card. Until the next time, guys, thanks for watching.